What's up, guys, and welcome back to another episode of 30 and 30. In today's episode, we're going to talk about what is natural bodybuilding. Now, many of you know that I am a professional natural bodybuilder, but some people don't actually know what natural bodybuilding is. So I figured I'd make a video on pretty much what it is and what it exactly means to be a quote-unquote natural bodybuilder. Now, a lot of people who know bodybuilding automatically associate bodybuilding with steroids. You know, they look at people like Arnold Schwarzenegger or Phil Heath, and they automatically think, okay, that's what bodybuilding must be. You know, the freaks, the Ronnie Colemans, the 300 pounders on stage. Well, natural bodybuilding, it's still the same sport, but it is totally different. Although those people choose to take certain substances, you know, in natural bodybuilding, we're not allowed to take substances that directly influence our hormones. So, you know, guys that compete in the NPC, I'm not saying everybody, but more often than not, they're running things, you know, like testosterone if you're a male. And we all know that as natural bodybuilders, that's one of the many things that we can't take. So this is not necessarily to divide natural bodybuilding versus enhanced bodybuilding, but just to prove to you guys what natural bodybuilding actually is. So when some people may think that natural bodybuilding is essentially you cannot take anything. Well, that's far from the truth. We do have a banned substance list, and some organizations are different, but more often than not, there's gonna be a lot of similar overlap when it comes to the banned substance list. So there are certain, you know, compounds on there that we're not allowed to take because, you know, they think that it gives people an unfair advantage within a sport. And one big banned substance list that a lot of organizations follow would be considered WADA. The World Anti-Doping Agency comes out with a list every single year, and that is used in college sport and in the Olympics. Well, that may be a great one to use. That doesn't necessarily follow within our sport of natural bodybuilding because it's such a unique sport. So some people choose to develop their own list, once again, based off of WADA, but they have some substances that are not on WADA that they still feel like aren't necessarily the need to be on that list so that they're approved. But what natural bodybuilding is we have to still stay within our means of the banned substances. And that list does get updated frequently. Every year, you know, organizations add new substances from year to year. I'm not saying every year, but more often than not they do. It might be one or two. And then besides the banned substance list, what we also do in order to make sure that we're natural is the first thing that we always do is we take a polygraph test before we compete. So the day before our competition, 2 days before our competition, depends when you roll into town at your show, they hook you up and you actually take a lie detector test. And I've had many of these done over the years. And yes, some people may say that lie detectors are not bulletproof, they're not admissible in the court of law. Oh, well, that's fine, you know, but I'm not saying that anyone out there who's competing in natural bodybuilding is like a trained FBI agent who can beat polygraph test. And those people who claim that, oh, they could beat a polygraph test, more often than not, they're just talking out of their ass. They've probably actually never taken one before because they're actually pretty difficult, especially the questions that they ask you. And they ask you multiple times in different ways just to make sure that's the first level. So yes, okay, awesome. If you do get past the polygraph, which doesn't really happen, then those people who compete, we take drug tests. So at all the shows that I've done, especially as a professional this last year, right after you get off stage, I mean, you literally have your medal around your neck. They're whisking you away to the back room to take a urine test. And this past year, I actually had, and this is, you know, this is how serious it is. I had somebody not stand and watch me pee into the cup directly, but they stood behind me at the urinal. You know, I guess I could say it. Before I took the test, they made me like pull down my pants to make sure like I didn't have a bag of urine on me, because guys try to cheat like that. So they test us pretty good. And a lot of the guys who go to these shows, I haven't been tested in the off season when I've been to a particular show. You know, maybe it'll happen to me this year, but I've seen it all the time. You know, we actually get pulled aside at these shows when they do have these other drug tests going on, and do a random drug test on a professional athlete like myself to make sure that we don't have any banned substances in our system. So if I show up to an IPE show or an OCB show, they might pull me aside and say, "Hey, Brandon, you know, we want to get some urine from you. We want to make sure, you know, that you're clean." And I'm totally fine with that, because that helps the sport. You know, we still are allowed to take certain substances, and I this is another thing that I wanted to talk about, because when I did start competing back in the day, I didn't take any supplements. I didn't even take protein, and I like prided myself upon that. But over the years, obviously, I've upped my supplement game, and I still stay within the realms which I choose to use, you know, within the banned substance list. But, you know, natural bodybuilding isn't just you show up on competition day without taking any supplements. You know, you don't just show up, because that would be a genetic contest. You know, oh, lifting weights isn't natural. Well, of course, you know, we're not necessarily made to lift weights. We are made to work. So it's not a genetic contest. It is a natural bodybuilding contest. So yes, you know, we still can augment our bodies in certain ways, just within the natural limits. So to get back to, you know, natural bodybuilding versus enhanced, obviously there's a lot of similarities. It's still judged, you know, more or less the same. You know, it's the same categories, the same criteria. They do look for slightly different looks. You know, they look for the lot larger look when it comes to the enhanced bodybuilding, but that's fine. Really what it comes down to is whether or not, you know, they abide by a banned substance list. And I will say this for one last thing. Because of law, the NPC and the IFBB actually do have to have a banned substance list. One of the loopholes is you just don't have to enforce it. Because technically these are illicit substances that are usually on these banned substances list. So they have to have it, you know, for their competitors to review. You just don't have to administer drug tests. You don't have to kick people out. Within natural bodybuilding, if you get caught, a lot of the organizations are a 7-year ban, and I more recently saw a 10-year ban come out this last year if you do get caught with one of these substances. And sometimes in different organizations, it's actually a lifetime ban. So we take this very, very seriously. Yes, you know, there might be guys out there that are trying to cheat the system, but, you know, as a professional athlete, and I'll say this, if you compete as much as we do, you know, multiple times in a given year, someone's going to screw up if they're trying to cheat the system. They're going to get caught on polygraph tests, they're going to get caught on a urine test, and they're going to get kicked out. So at the very high professional level, the guys that come back year after year after year, I am not concerned at all with these guys being unnatural, because if they're coming back, you know, in a decade, you know, let's say we compete, you know, 20 to 30 times, and that's an understatement. You know, that's a lot of times for someone to get off, you know, to screw up on a polygraph test if you're taking that many tests. And like myself, you know, I competed 3-4 times last year. Some of these other guys competed 8-9 times last year. So within natural bodybuilding, you know, you have to go through the checks and the balances in order to compete. And especially at the high level, sure, you know, you might get some scumbag that comes in at a local show and tries to undercut the system to win it, you know, pass the polygraph and attempt to pass the urine test, get caught in the urine test, just to try to snag, you know, a first place finish. But as you work your way up the system, the more and more you compete, the more guys that you see come back year after year after year, those guys are probably going to be natural more often than not, because of just the sheer amount of time that they have to. And let's be honest, guys, within natural bodybuilding, as awesome that it is, as much as I love it, I don't think anyone's making a living from competing in natural bodybuilding. One guy last year, Meshack O'Shea, he won like every single show that he did. He did 9 shows. I didn't add it up by any means. But, you know, maybe he netted, you know, maybe 15 grand. And that's a maybe from his winnings all year. And no one is making a living off of that. You know, guys like myself make a living off of coaching. But we're not necessarily making a living off of competing. So what am I getting at here? It's essentially, it'd probably be a waste of time to try to compete as a natural bodybuilder if you're trying to make a living off of it, especially if you're running performance enhancers that cost a lot of money because you would just never make up your losses, you know, from essentially buying the steroids and stuff like that to compete in a natural bodybuilding show and not make your money back. And that's why guys choose to compete like in the NPC IFBB, where they can actually make a lot of money. So guys, that's really what natural bodybuilding is. It's essentially pushing our bodies to the limit with staying within our means, you know, of what is deemed natural. We do use the drug testing standards. A lot of us use WADA. So that is, you know, what the Olympic standards are. You know, we have polygraph tests, we have the urine test, and that's how we stay within our checks and our balances. And that's what we call natural bodybuilding. And I will be natural for the entirety of my life. I love natural bodybuilding. I'm not about to be putting other substances in my body that could potentially hurt me. You know, you see these guys that die at a very, very young age from enlarged hearts that are 26. I'm sure you guys all know who I'm talking about. You know, and it's just something that I don't want to wish upon anyone, is obviously an early death. But when you see these things happen a lot over time, with these athletes that are using these substances and they die, you know, it's a shame to see that. And that's why I always am here to promote natural bodybuilding. So if you're out there, if you're a young guy, and if you're or a girl looking to get into the sport, you know, I always push for you to stay natural, to compete in natural bodybuilding, just because, in my opinion, it's definitely the healthier method to go to, and you can do it for a lifelong time. You know, there's guys out there, one girl in particular, I'm pretty sure she's like 15 years old, you know, and there's people out there who are competing well into their 70s. So if you could compete in bodybuilding for that long, that's awesome, and you should keep doing it. So guys, tune in for tomorrow for another episode of 30 and 30. I'll see you then.